All right, guys. I think that the price is moving so fast these days that at the time when I will publish the video, probably the situation will change drastically. But still, let's look at some longer time frames to see the general trend. And if you want some online updates, please go to Telegram, Twitter. There I publish charts and my thoughts more frequently. All right, so what happened? You remember last time I was telling you guys that the sentiment in the market is becoming more and more bullish and people are talking about 11,000, 11,500. So as usual, the price goes against the crowd and we see instead of the continuation of the rise, we see the drop. Moreover, again, on Telegram, I just posted earlier today that this trend line is too obvious to hold, and indeed it was broken. A lot of the stop orders for the long positions were triggered and some of the positions probably were liquidated. That's why we have relatively higher volume. It's probably a lot of the manipulation here because it's too coordinated, too huge drop to be expected from the minor players like combining together. From the standpoint of the technical analysis, what do we have here? First, of course, we had a pullback from 50% of Fibonacci retracement, and then we tested 38.2%, couldn't go down, and instead of reaching the new test of 50%, we went down again and broke this retracement level. We actually had a brief stop at 23.6% and then had a dip below that. In fact, as I said, for the major move over here, if the price would go somewhere around $9,200-$300, I wouldn't expect it to be a recovery after that. Probably we will go even lower. And the major low for this correction of $9,000 also is like the last point. If we'll go below that, I would say the whole bull market is in a big danger then, especially if we'll hold below this level. So the same thing is here. If we will go even lower and close this move to 100%, reaching something like $9,500, then I would say that the chances for continuation of the fall would be much, much higher. At the same time, we actually could stay in between of 0 and 23.6%, just the same way we did with this move, and then we could have a correction to the upside and then have a chance to continuation of the growth. But so far, chart looks pretty terrible, I must say. There is almost no pullback, there is almost no volume except the stop orders liquidation volume, and although most of the indicators are looking pretty oversold and seemingly are pointing out to the upside, still they can continue to be oversold for a while and we will see even a bigger drop. However, what is good right now? The good thing is that we still have our support in the major ascending descending channel. This is ascending one, this is descending channel, and in fact price had a test of the bottom of ascending channel already fourth time over here. It doesn't go well below that, and as soon as we are continuing going inside the intersection of these channels, we are still okay. But if we will hold below that, especially on a daily time frame, then it is not a good news, guys. So right now we are kind of playing with fire. Should also say that potential targets for the recovery, for the pullback, if the drop will continue, then on a daily time frame I would say that first of all we have, of course, our support of this ascending channel. Second thing is that we have our 100 days moving average, which is almost at $9,900 at the moment. And just as we had the pullback from this moving average right here, we may have it in this area as well. Actually, pretty similar to what happened when we had a transition from the global bear market in 2018 to the bull market, when we had a pullback from 200 weeks moving average. So it was tested like twice almost, and then we had a move to the upside through the sideways for a while, but in any case it was a reversal. So the same may happen right here, and a little bit below that moving average we have also the lower Bollinger band, which is somewhere at $9,700. And by the way, we had not only the pullback from a 50% Fibonacci retracement level, but also from the baseline of the Bollinger band, so on a daily time frame. So you see how all those levels and trend lines converged at those points. But again, if we will make a pierce below, let's say, 100 moving average and will not stay there, it's still fine. But if not, if we'll first test $9,500, then the probability that we'll go lower would increase drastically. And then the next level of $9,090, if we'll test this level, I would say that we can say goodbye to this bull market for a long period of time. But still, we have some hope. It's just the period of time when there's a lot of blood in the streets, so just use your stop orders, be cautious, and everything will be fine. By the way, speaking about the uncertainty, there is a fear and greed index for Bitcoin dropping to 11 today again, also a very low level, exactly the same that was somewhere around here. So usually at that point we have at least some pullback and move to the upside. And moreover, SOPR indicator also had a dive below 1, which also means the end of the correction, or at least the fact that the end of the correction is very, very close. So long story short, I think that we either will finally end with this move and continue to climb higher, or we'll have a lot of problem in front of us. But I will keep you updated, and so far I hope that it was useful. Thank you for watching.